Doug Shepherd of J&D Fitness Group. I recommend when you're determining how long you should jump rope that you start with a 1 minute interval. Again, let's think about what type of exercise is jumping rope. It's a cardiovascular exercise. So we're gonna go back to intensity level, meaning we wanna elevate our heart rate. And the analogy I like to make is comparing your body to a car. Once you turn the key in the ignition, it takes time for the oil from the oil pan to work its way through the engine. Well, that's how your heart works with blood. Once you initiate your exercise or jumping rope, it's gonna take time for blood to circulate up through the heart, into the lungs, and work through your body. So I recommend starting with a minute. If a minute is too much and you can't do that, I recommend by simply just running in place. By here pumping the arms, you can build up your endurance and your stamina, and then you can start a minute with the rope. Now, for a lot of people, it's the skill set of actually jumping rope they have the challenge with. But again, over time and through repetition, you'll learn to master that. Once you've gotten a minute, you're able to complete, then I would recommend adding on 30 seconds at a time. So working from a minute and a half to 2 minutes, 2.5 minutes, and then from there, it's endless. But again, start with a minute and progress 30 seconds at a time. Again, when doing your jumping rope, remember mechanics, the ideal driving force of the lower leg is the ankle bounce. So we never want the heel to hit the ground. And that's how long I'd recommend when determining how long the jump rope.